सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरि ओम। भगवद्गीता 12th चैप्टर 10th वर्स। श्री कृष्णा इज गिविंग मोर ऑप्शंस टू अर्जुना और टू ऑल डिवोटीज। इन द प्रीवियस वर्स ही सेज दैट इफ इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर यू टू स्टडीली फोकस ऑन मी देन फॉलो अभ्यास योगा। दैट मीन्स द योगा ऑफ प्रैक्टिस वेयर वन ट्राइज टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट वंस माइंड ऑन द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ वर्शिप एंड देन when the mind wanders from the object of worship, that person brings back that mind to the object of worship or meditation. Abhyasa yoga. Now in the 10th verse, Shri Krishna says that if one cannot practice even this abhyasa yoga, then what should one do? Abhyase api asamarthosi matkarmam paramo bhava मदर्थम अपि कर्माणि कुर्वन् सिद्धिम अवाप्स्यसि। अभ्यासे इन प्रैक्टिस अपि आल्सो असमर्थ है अनेबल टू प्रैक्टिस असि इफ यू आर मत कर्म परम है इंटेंड ऑन डूइंग एक्शंस इंटेंट ऑन डूइंग एक्शंस फॉर माय सेक दैट इज फॉर द सेक ऑफ द लॉर्ड और गॉड। सो डूइंग एक्शंस फॉर गॉड भव बी you madartham for my sake karmani actions kurvan by doing api even siddhim perfection avapsyasi you shall attain. So if abhyase api asamartha hai asi if you are unable to practice even abhyasa yoga that means if it is impossible for you to even practice properly regularly then mat karma paramo bhava then you just do actions for me that means offer the results of all actions to me and madartham api karmani kurvan even by doing actions for my sake that is offering all the actions to me and the actions and also the fruits of actions to me you will attain avapsyasi siddhim you will attain perfection. So for attaining perfection the best method is to constantly meditate or worship on God with one pointed focus. If that is not or meditate on the undifferentiated unconditioned Brahman. If these two are not possible, then fix your mind and intellect on God. If that is also not possible, then do the practice of fixing the mind and intellect on God. Abhyasa yoga. If that is also not possible, then surrender all your works and the results of all the works to God. Because even by surrendering the results of one's works or the works to God, one attains perfection. Then he says in the 11th verse, Athai dadapya shaktosi kartum madhyogam ashritah sarva karma falatyagam tatah kuru yatatmavan. So atha, if, api, even, etat this kartum to do ashaktah unable asi you are tatah then madhyogam refuge in me shelter in me ashritah taking yatatmavan self controlled sarva karma phala tyagam give up or renounce all the fruits of all actions kuru do that. So do renunciation, renounce the fruits of all actions. So again another option is given. God is so gracious that God is giving more than 1, 2, 3 options to attain God. Sri Ramakrishna says that the goal of human life is God realization. So to attain that Parama Purushartha or Charama Purushartha, the final goal of human life, Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha, the final goal is Moksha. To attain that, God is giving various paths. So he says, the path which he has given here is, even if you are unable to, you do things for me, that means surrender all your works to me. If you are unable to do even that, then take refuge in me, take shelter in me, and give up fruits of all actions and be self-controlled. Yatatmavan means control your sense organs and give up all actions, fruits of all actions to me. Fruits of all actions to me. Renounce sarva karma falatyagam. You renounce and give fruits of all actions to me. So here, the practitioner, Arjuna, is being told, but through Arjuna, every one of us is being instructed that if you can concentrate your mind on God, if you are unable to do that, then you practice Abhyasa Yoga, where you repeatedly try to concentrate your mind on God, you fail, again try, you fail, again try, etc. If that is also not possible, then do actions for God. That means, do something explicitly for God, or whatever you do, surrender those actions to God. And then, even if you cannot do that even, then if you want to do things for your personal desires, personal motives, then you give up all the fruits of all actions to God. That means you should not expect fruits, you should not think about fruits, you should not care for the fruits or results of actions. You should not dwell on the results of actions. So that is why, because you should know that it is dependent on Lord, on God. Fruits of the action are dependent on God. So if you cannot control your mind, if you cannot even practice control of mind, then you have to be indifferent to the results of your actions. You have to be indifferent to the results of your actions. Then Sri Krishna is giving a gradation of different kinds of spiritual practices. He is giving gradations of different kinds of spiritual practices. He is saying, Shreyo hi jnanam abhyasat. Jnanat dhyanam vishishyate. Dhyanat karma falat tyagah. Tyagat shantir anantaram. Abhyasat. So, rather than doing abhyasa yoga, means more than abhyasa yoga, jnanam hi shreyah. Knowledge is better. So, knowledge is better than simply repeating. Abhyasa here is not referring to practice, but blind repetition, automatic repetition, or mechanical repetition. That is what is being referred to here. So, better than mechanical or blind repetition or abhyasa practice is jnanam, knowledge. And jnanad dhyanam vishishyate. And better than knowledge is meditation. एंड ध्यानात् कर्म फल त्याग है एंड बेटर देन मेडिटेशन इज द गिविंग अप ऑफ द फ्रूट्स ऑफ एक्शंस रिनन्सिएशन ऑफ द फ्रूट्स ऑफ एक्शंस कर्म फल त्याग है रिनन्सिएशन ऑफ द फ्रूट्स ऑफ एक्शंस एंड त्यागात शांति अनंतरम सो इमीडिएटली फ्रॉम रिनन्सिएशन कम्स पीस इमीडिएटली फ्रॉम रिनन्सिएशन कम्स पीस सो फर्स्ट यू डू नॉट गो फॉर ब्लाइंड इमिटेशन और ब्लाइंड प्रैक्टिस देन बेटर देन ब्लाइंड प्रैक्टिस और ऑटोमेटिक और मैकेनिकल प्रैक्टिस इज नॉलेज एंड बेटर देन नॉलेज is dhyana meditation and better than meditation is the giving up or renunciation of the fruits of action and by doing the fruits of renouncing the fruits of action by doing this giving up of fruits of actions anantaram immediately you get shantihi you get peace so renunciation of the fruits of action which already has been seen in karma yoga in gita karmani eva adhikarah te ma phalishu kadachana there shri krishna is telling that one has rights only to actions and not to the fruits thereof so giving up the fruits of actions is considered the proper sannyasa proper renunciation so It is a common thing which has to be done no matter whatever path you take in spiritual life. Unless fruits of actions are given up, one cannot attain peace. So, a person who is engaged in devotional exercises, a person of wisdom, And also a person who is not aware of devotional exercises, is not aware of different paths of spiritual practice. In the case of both of them, renunciation of the fruits of action is the one of the easiest means to attain ananda, peace. Ananda is attained or It's not a proper translation, but the closest is bliss, is attained by giving up the fruits of all actions. And so that is, and the moment you do that, immediately, anantaram, you get shanti. In Tamil Nadu, there was this famous saint called Thiruvalluvar, who has written 1,330 couplets called Kurals, Thirukural they are called. So there is one Thirukural, Yadanin Yadanin Ningiyan Nodal Adanin Adanin Ilan. Means Nodal means attachment. So from whatever object, from whatever your attachment is removed, from that you will not have any sorrow, any misery. So that is what is being told here in this shloka. If you give up the fruits of action, If you give up attachment to fruits of action, then immediately, anantaram shantihi, you attain to peace. In the 13th verse, Shri Krishna says, Adveshta sarva bhutanam, maitraha karuna evacha, nirmamo nirahankaraha, samadukha sukhakshami, santushtaha satatam yogi, yatatma dridanishchayaha, मय्यर्पित मनोबुद्धि ही यो मद्भक्त समय प्रिय है सो हु इज मद्भक्त है माई डिवोटी नाउ श्री कृष्ण हियर स्टार्ट्स गिविंग क्वालिटीज ऑफ अ ट्रू डिवोटी ऑफ गॉड सो ही सेज हु इज माई ट्रू डिवोटी और हु इज माई ग्रेट डिवोटी अद्वेष्टा सर्वभूतानाम अद्वेष्टा ए पर्सन who is free from hatred to all the creatures, free from hatred to all living beings. Maitraha also who is friendly, and Karuna, who is compassionate, evacha, to all living beings. Nirmamah means who does not have the idea of mama, mamakara, mine, who is free from the idea of mine. And nirahankara, one who is free from the idea of egoism, that is the notion of I. So one who is free from the idea of I and mine, ahankara, mamakara, samadukha, sukha, shami. So one who is forbearing, one who can bear both sukha and dukkha, satatam, ever, santushta, content, one who can bear sukha and dukkha, and one who is ever content, yogi, one who is steady in contemplation, and yatatma, one who is self-controlled, dhrida nishchaya, one who is possessed of firm conviction, mayi, in me, arpita mano buddhihi, with mind and intellect fixed, yaha, who, madbhakta, devoted to me, saha, that may, to me, priya, is dear. So, a person who does not hate Adveshta, does not hate any living being, has friendliness and compassion to all living beings, and is not having the idea of mine or I, and is forbearing or maintains one's perseverance, same-sightedness in both misery and happiness, one who is happy always, santushta, happy means content, but who is steady in contemplation, and yatatma, one who is self-controlled, one who is possessed of firm conviction, and one who has given one's mind and intellect fixed in me. Me means God. Yaha, that person, madbhakta hai. That person is my devotee, or that person is devoted to me and is dear to me. Same priya hai, is dear to me. I like that person because that person has this quality of being free from the effect of dualities of human nature. So I like that person. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Tat Sat. Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.